products that you guys can get if you are a beginner lash tech, or if you are already an experienced lash tech and just want to try for alternative lash products. So yeah, all these products I'm going to show you guys, you can find on Amazon. So this is an Amazon friendly, because if you're anything like me, I love Amazon. So if I can find something, I'm gonna do it. Best believe. But yeah, if I don't have the actual like vendor I got it from, you guys can still find it in the description box. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get started, and I hope you guys enjoy. So the first thing I guess I'll talk about are the lash trays that I got off there. I'm gonna talk about three different ones. So the first one I have is Vava Lash, and I have the 0.7 D curl 16 millimeter lashes, and these are my, obviously, my volume fanning lashes, and these are self fanning lashes, which is perfect for beginner lash techs if you're still struggling with homemade fans, or if you just need some practice with doing it. This is definitely one that I recommend. It helps keep a thin base when you are doing your fans. They range between $8 and $11. And then the next one that I'm going to talk about is QL lashes, and these are also volume fanning lashes, easy self fanning lashes, D curl 0.7s, and this is 11 millimeter, and then I have 14 millimeter, and these are really good. They're really, really pretty. They're really soft. I like to use 0.7s just because it gives that thicker effect to your lash set. For a classic lash, I have T-Dance. This is 0.15 C-Curl 14 millimeter. I don't like to use anything over a 0.18 because it'll be too heavy on the natural lash, and that's when you can cause damage. And I also have some 0.18s, which are a little thicker. These are a D-Curl. So I'll show you the difference between the two side by side. And you can see the D curl curls upwards more than the C curl does, which I actually like using D curl in my set. So the next thing I'm gonna talk about are tweezers, I guess, and these are actually from QL as well. They come in three. They also give you two different isolating tweezers, which I like because sometimes clients that have straighter lashes, I like to use a straight isolating tweezer, but for my clients that have more curlier lashes, I like to use a curved one just because it's easier to separate and isolate through the layers. These tweezers also pick up lashes really, really well because it has a tight grip, and these tweezers were about $10. The next thing, which is very important, is a portable fan. It's really powerful, really strong, and it feels good. It's not like, it's not too strong to where it's gonna make your eyes water, but it's strong enough to do the job. This is the Fly Item mini portable fan. It comes with a charger and everything, so you just plug the charger up right there and charge it. It has a little kickstand on the back. I don't use it, so obviously you see I don't know how to do it, but it has a kickstand on the back for if you want to use it that way, but I don't really recommend that. The next thing I'm going to talk about is tape. It's really important to have a strong tape, strong enough to hold the lashes down, but also not too strong to irritate the skin or irritate the lashes when you are removing or applying. The tape I have right here is the Ibanku Micropore fabric tape, and it's in pink. I think they had a green one as well. They stick well, so it's not gonna have any lifting. They're not gonna move whether your clients have oily skin. If they have runny eyes, the tape is not gonna go anywhere. It's gonna stay still, which is what you want, because you don't wanna have any moving because it can irritate your clients, and you don't want that. And another tape, I forgot the brand of this, but I'll put it in the description box. It's actually a medical tape, which I like because it sticks very well to the skin. It sticks really nice to the skin, and it has a nice easy peel off. So yeah. So the next thing I'm gonna talk about is are the Hydro Gel Pads. And they have like a jelly consistency to them, so it lays on the skin really, really nice. What I'm gonna talk about is glue, which is something that is really important to have. Different glues work for different people. You know, some glues dry faster than others. Some glue works in different humidity, which is a very important key to lashing. You want to make sure that your humidity and your temperature corresponds to the glue that you're using and the environment that you're using that you're lashing in, because it definitely helps with retention, and it definitely helps with the actual application. So the glue that I have is Stacy Lash Extra Strong Lash Adhesive. It's a professional lash glue. So the drying time is 0.5 to 1 second. The lasting time is up to 7 week retention. Viscosity of it is very low, and the viscosity is pretty much how thick it is. It's not too thick, but it's also not too watery. Flexibility very high, meaning you can use it for different sets, different type of lashes, different curl of lashes, different thickness of lashes. The fumes are higher because it's an extra strong glue. So I definitely recommend using this in a professional manner, because you don't want to be putting too much glue on the extension, because for one, that's harmful to the natural lash, and also the glue is strong and you don't want to accidentally drip any glue into your client's eye, because that ain't what you want to do. Also says that the skill level is expert and the humidity level is between 50 and 70% humidity, and the temperature is 70 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Once you open the bottle, it has a lasting time of 2 months. So usually what I do is after I open it, I'll write down the date of when it's time to throw it away, so I know not to use it past that date.
Have to go with that, I have this glue shaker. It's actually a nail shaker, a nail polish shaker, but I use it for a glue shaker. But you want to make sure that you do use a glue shaker instead of just using your hands to shake it, because it's not going to do it justice the way it needs to be, because you want to make sure that you are mixing all of the product together, the chemicals.
You also want to keep it in a closed, dry case. I also want to talk about these glue rings. I have, these are from Weco, I think. That's the vendor from Amazon that I got these glue rings from. And I love using glue rings. 100 of these for $3. These spoolies that I have, I bought this is a little glass case I got from Dollar Tree that I keep them in. But I have some pink ones. They come in pink and all black. These are from Go Worth disposable spoolies, and I got 100 of these for $5. Like I said, they come in pink and black. And I have these micro applicator brushes, and I like to use these for just to get any residue off of my client's lashes before I start applicating. You always want to applicate on fresh lashes, so this is just for cleanup pretty much, or prep. I mean, I got 500 of these for $7. And then the last thing I want to talk about is this ring light. I'll show you how bright it is. So it gets pretty bright. It's for the selfies, I think it works pretty good. It's not as good as my LED light, but for close-up selfie, it definitely improves picture, so that's why I like to use it. So yeah, so that's everything that I want to show you guys. So I hope that this video was helpful. I hope you guys enjoy, and I love you guys. Remember to stay true, stay happy, and yeah. All right, y'all.